We will follow our path. You follow yours. We have found a new path. This is the day of hope. This is the path of elevation and progress. This is not a new path. This path has not been borrowed from anywhere. This path is from here. It is purely Indian. The Buddhist religion survived here for 2,000 years in India. The principles preached by the Lord Buddha are immortal. But the Lord Buddha did not make such claim. There is a provision for change with the change of time. Such generosity is not found in any religion.
14th October 1956, a historic moment in the Buddhist history of India. The greatest Indian, Dr. Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar, popularly known as Baba Sahib, embraced Buddhism with millions of his followers. Buddhism, which teaches pragya, means understanding or wisdom, karuna means love, and samta means equality. Buddhism, a symbol of liberation. Liberation of human mind and body from the shackles of slavery enforced by Chaturvarna and the caste system. A conversion from slavery to humanity. A conversion for accepting Buddhism. This conversion embarked in history as Dhamma Chakra Pravartan. Dr. Ambedkar revived Buddhism in its own land, India, and the place in Nagpur, which was chosen for this conversion ceremony, is popularly known as Deekshabhoomi. Deekshabhoomi has become the place of revival for revolutionary Buddhism by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. It is a witness to the beginning of his vision of an enlightened India. Deekshabhoomi, the beginning of a revolution of liberty, equality, and fraternity, a revolution of human liberation, and a bloodless revolution. The humanistic and scientific Buddhism was born in India. Buddha taught compassion, loving kindness, equality and fraternity. When Buddhism was destroyed and erased from India, there came a dark time in the lives of Indian people. India faced and continued to face various issues like inequality, injustice, exploitations, atrocities, caste system, superstition, and many more. India desperately needed Buddhism for its enlightenment. In this situation, Deekshabhoomi offers a ray of hope for Indians to enlighten themselves through right mental transformation.
The world has seen many revolutions. When we talk about the revolutions that have taken place in the countries like France or in America or in China, or even when we think about the Russian Revolution, those revolutions were bloody revolutions. A lot of blood was shed in those revolutions and millions perished in those revolutions. In India, the revolution for the equal opportunity, for the equality, was taking place under the leadership of Baba Saheb Ambedkar, and he brought a phenomenal change in the lives of the people without shedding a single drop of blood. And in the history of the world, we have not seen such a revolution which had peace at its foundation. And we can say that Baba Saheb's revolution that he brought up on the Deekshabhoomi on 14th October 1956, we can surely say that that was a culmination of the bloodless, peaceful revolution that Babasaheb Ambedkar inaugurated into embracing Buddhism.
Nag people spread the teaching of Bhagwan Buddha all over the India. A fierce and frightening war went on between the Aryans and Nag people, and many Nag people died in that war. Over a period of time, few survivors of the war rehabilitated themselves around the area which is now called as Nagpur, meaning a city of Nags, the snakes. There flows in the middle of the city a famous river called Nagnadi in the local language. And this was the main reason for choosing Nagpur as a place for conversion ceremony. The geographical land spreads over 22 acres, covered with lush green sceneries. The central part is dedicated for the giant stupa. The stupa on Deekshabhoomi is a symbol of Buddhist culture. The great emperor Ashoka built many such stupas related to the life of Buddha and his Dhamma. Deekshabhoomi has resemblance with the famous stupa of Sachi in Madhya Pradesh. On the eastern side of Deekshabhoomi, one can find a monument of 22 vows given by Dr. Ambedkar for anyone who embraces the Buddhism. Some vows denies the god, goddesses and irrelevant customs and rituals. Some vows ascertains adherence to the Buddha, Dhamma and then to complete becoming of a Buddhist. There is another monument of preamble of the Constitution of India. At the eastern part, there is a Bodhi tree. It is the branch of Bodhi tree located at Anuradhapura, Sri Lanka, brought to Deekshabhoomi by Bhadanta Ananda Kausalyayan. The Bodhi tree in Anuradhapura, Sri Lanka was originally a sapling from the Bodhi Vruksha under which Buddha became enlightened at Bodh Gaya. Bodhi Vruksha, that is tree of awakening, is highly respected in Buddhist culture. The Bodhi Vruksha planted at Deekshabhoomi is the witness of the enlightenment of Buddha to the spread of Buddhism in Sri Lanka by King Ashoka and his dynasty, and of revival of Buddhism in Nagpur by Babasaheb Ambedkar. The campus is surrounded by Dr. Ambedkar College, a multi-faculty educational institution offering arts, commerce, and science streams. Other institutions are Dr. Ambedkar Law College, Dr. Ambedkar Institute of Management and Studies. The giant stupa at Deekshabhoomi is a famous architecture by late Mr. Shiv Danmal. It is backed up by his deep study of Buddhist architecture around the world for more than 2 years. The construction began in July 1978, and for the first time in Asia, central block locking system in construction, a hollow globe like structure was used. The height of the stupa is 90 feet. It has a diameter of 120 feet with the capacity to accommodate around 5,000 people. The ground floor space is more than 20,000 square feet and is meant for group sittings and prayers. There is a library, museums and auditoriums in the basement. The stupa is supported by four expanding arrangements of 16 columns at the first, 16 columns at the second, 24 at the third, and the last layer of 24 columns again. The funding for construction is arranged by Maharashtra government of ₹1.2 crore, central government of ₹20 lakh, and MP government of ₹10 lakh. The followers of Babasaheb donated their hard-earned money towards the construction of stupa. Soon after 50 days of conversion, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar passed away on 6th December 1956, leaving behind his dream of enlightened India on the shoulders of his followers.
Before Baba Saheb Ambedkar embraced Buddhism on 14th October 1956, we can say that the period before that was the dark period for Buddhism in India. And Baba Saheb Ambedkar brought a new light in India by embracing Buddhism with half of his half million followers at the Deekshabhoomi. And since then, in India, the Buddhist population has increased manifold, and the conversions have been taking place throughout last 70 years about everywhere throughout our country, and it has dramatically changed the attitude of people towards the history of India, and also it has brought a radical change in the lives of millions of people who are practicing Buddhism, walking on the footsteps of Baba Saheb Ambedkar towards Buddha.
The total Buddhist population in the world is around 10%. Dr. Ambedkar has a lion's share in increasing the Buddhist population worldwide. As per the available statistics, around 7 lakh people converted to Buddhism on 14th October 1956 at Nagpur, around 3 lakh at Chandrapur, around 10 lakh on 7th to 9th December 1956 after the death of Dr. Ambedkar. The total reached around 15 to 20 millions in 1959, that is in just 3 years of his death. After the conversion, scheduled caste people made noticeable progress in their overall livelihood. They left their dirty traditional occupations and adopted modern occupations like doctors, engineers, professors, fashion designing, information technology, advocacy, etc. There was great upliftment in their economic status. Some are seen in business worlds too. They started investing in the education of their kids and future generation. A remarkable improvement and progress has been seen when oppressed class people embrace Buddhism.
There has been some tremendous transformation in the scheduled caste community after conversion to Buddhism. These Buddhists developed in multiple sectors. They believe that hard work, education, and rational thoughts result in progress. They got the inspiration to live as a human being due to Buddhism. It aroused their self-respect and made it possible for them to seek all-round development. They have progressed not only in conventional fields like education, social, economic, but also in culture, literature, art, etc. Buddhist people are marching towards development and light only because of Buddhism.
Deekshabhoomi is also a place of women liberation in India. Gautam Buddha established gender equality by establishing Bhikkhuni Sangha at his time. Buddhism began as to treat the women and men equal with respect to personal development by following the path of spiritualism. 14th October 1956, Buddhist conversion ceremony conducted by Dr. Ambedkar marked the golden page of history. It was the only moment in Buddhist history with such a large number of people getting converted to Buddhism. One can mainly see bookstalls on the program of Dhamma Chakra Pravartan at Deekshabhoomi. The recorded selling cost is around Rs. 100 million on Dhamma Chakra Pravartan day. It is nothing less than the book fair organized across the globe, like Tehran, Colombia, Bogota, and Jerusalem Book Festival. Deekshabhoomi is visited by many international visitors, researchers, scientists, and Buddhist scholars. Every year, Deekshabhoomi is visited by millions of followers to offer respect, greetings, and salutation to Buddha and Ambedkar. Every year, they visit to get new motivation and new energy.
Victim site, you must keep self-confidence and make effort. As Baba Sahib, you see, led, you see, non-violent way, mainly through education. Then the other side, their side also now must show reconciliation well. And must follow the ethics, equality for everybody.
However, your responsibility is great too. Your behavior should be such that all the people will honor and respect you. Do not think that this religion means we have got stuck with the cops around our neck. As far as the Buddhism is concerned, the land of India is of no account. We must resolve to follow the Buddhist religion in the finest way. It should not happen that the Mahar people brought the Buddhism to disgrace. So we must have firm determination. If we accomplish this, then we will thrive ourselves, our nation, and not only that, but the whole world. Because the Buddhist religion only will be the savior of the world. Unless there is justice, there will be peace in the world.